Side B TV.
Phil Jackson, Side B TV, Jersey Fresh Jam. Check us out right here. Everybody doing their thing. My man Prime Prolific rocking with Rich Mahogany, Soul Zales, Tone Live. Yo, it's crazy right now. We're going to give y'all a good tour around here too, man, because the Graph Rider's been here since 10 o'clock. The joint started at 10 o'clock in the morning. It's going to end 9 at night, I believe. Probably 10 or 11, whatever. We on New York Ave, Trenton, New Jersey. TerraCycle Center. Crazy. Come on, man. Check the graffiti out. We got people. Everything's cultural. It's all good. Everybody love. We got a vendor out here. What's your name, my man?
Come on, man. It's Big Next, Infamous Magazine, number one graffiti magazine on the planet right now, based right out of Philadelphia. As you see right here, we run multiple covers of each of our issues. This right here was a cover that was done by SP1 for issue number 4. That one right there was the Pose 2 cover that we did for issue number 3. You can check us out online, www.theinfamousmag.com. You know, look for them drawings. We're everywhere, man. We're in 600 different stores, over 30,000 in distribution. We're not only here in the U.S., we're also in Puerto Rico. We'll ship out to any other country as well. So if you see something on the site that you like, check it out. Plus, on top of that, September 3rd, that's when we're releasing the app on iTunes. So definitely check that drawing out. Fully interactive, supporting the culture, doing what we do. Remember, that's www.theinfamousmag.com. If you want to get at us, you can reach me. That's nex@theinfamousmag.com, or follow me on Twitter @Africanon. That's AFRICANNON on Twitter. All right, y'all, get with me.
Dope. Yo, as we proceed, as you can see, this is some of the most beautiful of these things in the world, man. I kind of understand where Keith Murray was coming from, you know what I mean? Because look at this right here. I was actually out here when it was just a blueprint. Now they detailing the face to it. By nighttime, it's going to be a real person. You can just walk out the wall, feel me? For real. Phil Jackson is not saying anything right now because I think he's more captivated than anything, because this is some greatness out here, bro. What you think?
This is incredible. When I first walked up, because you know they had like the garden variety thing at night, but when you see it in actually in the daytime, I'm blown away by this, man. I love the graffiti. I love the vendors out here. We're gonna get interviews from the artists, from the vendors, everybody that's involved with this, man. So stay tuned. Divine Jummer, Phil Jackson, Side B TV, Side B Radio, WPRB 103.3 FM. We want to go out now. Want to walk around?
Let's take a tour around, because the graffiti is crazy, man. I want to get this art on camera, because they deserve this, man, for real. They out here tagging it. People need to see this. Let's go. Hey, guess what? We're actually about to run to the core person of this whole event. His name is Will Casa, right here.
Yo.
What's good, brother?
What's good, family?
Hey, man, from what I heard, they was out here since 10 o'clock this morning, man, doing this beautifulness, earlier than that, because of the culture. We also have a hip-hop killer in the building, you know what I'm saying, that I mess with personally, love his music all the time. My brother, Venomous 2000. What's happening, brother? Where's Priority?
Going to get something to eat right now, man.
Oh, he's here. Yeah.
So he's here. Okay, so then we get to Priority. That's my brother right there, Priority on the beats, no doubt.
Peace, family.
Yo, what's going on out here, man?
I'm feeling good right now. Right now, man, you got the 7th annual Jersey Fresh Jam, you know? We've been doing this 7 years strong. This is our biggest one ever. You know what I'm saying? We got like 20 MCs performing, including Venomous right here. You know, we got over 50 graffiti artists from all over the state, the tri-state, really. You know, from all the way here up to New York and in between, you know?
Dope.
Yeah, so we doing it big over here, man.
So how long is it supposed to go on, man?
All the way to the end of the night, like 9, 10 o'clock.
Ha, like that, like that, like that.
And when did this start? When did the Jersey Fresh actually start?
The Jersey Fresh as a jam? Like, the official name came in 08. You know what I'm saying? Before that, we was calling it the TerraCycle Jam. Because it was only, like, for graffiti writers. Like, the music, it was just always, like, you know, we would bring our radio or we'd get somebody to DJ for a quick few. Last year is when the music became more of a highlight, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, okay, we got to organize it better this year. Get cats from all over, you know what I'm saying? Local, mix it all in, you know? And it becomes a liver event, you know, because you're celebrating all the elements. You're celebrating the culture now just instead of one aspect of it, you know? Yeah. So
man,
it's
love it, yeah. Out there, man.
Me being a hip-hop artist and just a fan of it, man, I respect all this, you know what I mean? That's why I said we have to walk all the way around because I don't want nobody to be unseen. This right here has to be seen, man. And as long as we giving you a media, you know, a place for you to do so, it's all my pressure. Word.
Get a close-up. Get a close-up of my man's shirt. Then.
Because check it out. I was like, man, I couldn't find nothing, you know what I mean, to go with it, right? So I said, wait a minute. Let me take a picture of my sneaky row. Look at my sneaky row. I put it on my shirt.
With the matching hat.
Yo, let's roll, B.
Yo, it's Tone Laird from the Remarkable Mayors down by the Green Llama Movement. Represent Side B TV. They represent nothing but the dirty Jersey underground hip hop and everything that's moving in the underground. Respect. Peace.
On princess, somebody's girl, she probably might be one. I know a real bad when I see one. I'm like, if it was me, I keep hun, because she the kind of girl in the knee, son. No games, I'm serious, I think I really like her. Oh Lord, she's it, I'll wife her. Hoping I can get close enough to try her. Man, I will lock her down, life her. Cause she the baddest in the world. And all I think is how I'm supposed to make her my girl. Damn, I just wanna get the chance to please her. Look at Jay-Z and B, that could be us. You got what I need, I knew it. Let's not waste time, let's do it. Unites. You Michelle Obama, the president's wife. I done made my old girl jealous. On the red carpet, now my new chick famous. My dog told me lately I ain't focused now. Cause it's clear, shorty got me open now. She really got me spinning like a ceiling fan. I ain't in and out the clubs, I'm a different man. I used to play around with the groupies, yeah. Met her, then I gave the groupies up. Long hair, green eyes. True religious fitting tight around a mean thigh. I ain't tripping off of what my boy said. I'm just trying to be a boyfriend. And you ain't got to worry about them chicks, cause baby, you that Taraji. Shades on, you an actress. Nose turned up, walk like you that. I know exactly what you all about. The new Louis bag before it's even out. Yeah, baby, I know how to treat ya. Handcuffs, you a keeper.
So we can do it big life. Say Jay-Z, live that life.
Yeah, he doing that right there. That right there is dope. Let's go. Let's walk around, brother.
How much did they have of this wall done?
Most of, like I said, it was like more of a blueprint. They didn't do any of the filling in or anything like that yet. It was just straight blueprint. Like they had the idea down, and then once the colors start coming, like it's like they're growing a baby right now. They seeing more things, you know what I mean?
You think we could probably talk to one of them real quick?
Yeah, we probably can, yo. I mean, I ain't trying to stop no flow or whatever, but somebody can give me 2 minutes.
Let's get him.
Okay, yeah, because he seems closer. Wow. Hold on, son. I like this one right here in particular because he got the gazelles on. You know what I'm saying? Check my man out right there. You know what I mean? The Magoo or something with the gazelles on. He killing them right now. My man with the baby shoes teeth. Check him out. Von Drummer. My man Phil Jackson. What's your name, my man?
Mimic from Elizabeth, New Jersey.
TFC, BSK.
Okay. Graph writer. This is work right here. He doing this right now. Peep this. Craziness. It's all crazy. My man got the baby teeth, I told you. He got the baby shoes going on, you know what I mean? And this is just dope, man. It's beautiful, man, you know what I mean? And I like to see work like this because I'm a hip hop artist and I love it from the culture, from the ground up, everything when it first started and from which it came from, you know what I mean?
That's roots. That's his roots, yeah. It's where it came from.
Could you explain to the audience what this piece is about right here? Because this is like crazy dope right now.
It's a little collab between me and two partners of mine, Chuck over here and Elon at the end. Okay. I'm originally from Florida, so okay. I'm Miami, what have you. To bring that flavor up in here and mix it up with Jersey, New York, what have you. And we get this thing going on, you know? My friend Demmer VS brought us down, do a little artwork, what have you, and get this going. For Case 2, just passed away, and just to represent for the Jersey Fresh Jam.
So Case 2, he's an old tagger from up New York, I believe, right?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
He's an old school one right there. Allah bless his soul, man. Real talk. But, you know, back to work, man. We ain't going to hold you up because I see you doing more detail to what you're doing.
How long have you been a graph writer?
I'd say maybe like a good 5 to 10 years, give or take, you know, because it took a little while just to get going before I was out there on my own, you know, thanks to my peoples that taught me, what have you, Terms, Clear, Circle, all those guys from Miami, and coming up here to do my own thing, keep it going.
That's what's up. Hey, before we get out of here, you got any shout-outs real quick for the camera? You can turn around right here.
Oh, yeah. All right. Big up to TFC, the Fresh Collection, BSK crew, all Miami, Jersey, New York heads. Keep it going. Keeping it real. Keep Graph alive.
Take
dope, dope, dope. Yo, we about to make another round, man. It's too much out here, yo. We about to go see something else. Too much colors. I'm going to have so many shirts. I'm going to just take pictures of everything and have so many shirts. What's that, brother?
Out of all these pieces right here that we're seeing.
Yes.
Which one is your favorite?
I think we're about to take a venture to it right now. The Smurfs. The Smurfs is crazy. The Smurfs is crazy. Look at this. Come walk in here, man. I don't know who did this. Yo, look at this piece right here. Beautiful.
Side B TV with your host Phil. My man Devon Drummer, he just went to the stage, about to go on. But we just wanted to get this artwork real quick. What's your name, sir?
Evac with FVA Crew.
That's what's up, man. Look, they told me to come back here to the back. Because this is probably one of the dopest pieces. Everything is dope, but how did you create this, man? Where did you get the creation? What was your thought from doing this right here?
We just get the idea for what's popular, you know, movies or sports or whatever that's popular at the time. And the movie just came out, so we just decided to, you know, do the Smurfs wall, you know.
So how long did it take you to do this today?
We've been out here since 7 in the morning. It was started a few weeks ago, so it's been planned for a little while now.
Hey, man, where can people get to look at more of your artwork like this, man? Because this is crazy.
You can go to fuacrew.org. Most of our work is on there, or 12oz.com.
All right, then, man. Hey, you want to give me any shout-outs before we get out of here, man?
A shout-out to the FUA crew. Shout-out to Mech. Put this work out here. Zone. Starters there at range. That's how we do.
Side B TV, Phil Jackson, Devon Drummers on the stage. And your name again?
Evac.
My man Evac, and we're signing out. Hey, let's go check out my man Scat and Feed Spittertainment real quick. Let's go.
First of all, with these bars, man, better than most of y'all. Death at the front door, don't want to miss your curtain call. Lyrically, I was born a ball, and the thing of all, just for the stars, I was born a star. Fuck your fancy cars.
People say once you build it, yes, they will come.
No doubt.
Message off the scattered in your mind, drum. Soul on the black man's side, nigga, now get you some. Offbeat claim to be hot, you gotta get my money.
Be for scrap, filled with bullet scars, and if you pull it far, you better squeeze it. Or else it's Lord help you, Jesus. Everything changes when it's shall release. Yeah. To the street shit, you better leave quick.
Venue after venue, we over there, no matter what. This is chess, not checkers, moving on the last one. Burning on that garden by
variety, choose one.
Kush, biff, full sour, and we make the track.
Yo, mom, where's the next beat for me to bomb? I'm the choir before the storm. What's the difference from Saddam, Osama, and Obama? They all original and have power in their palms. Fuck, they use drugs, they want to settle all they farm.
It's out of town, music, we move with it. So it's funny, it's out of town. Constitute right here, see? So we need to climb a man to help, handle help. So don't get out of
town. Hey, yo, weed man need to come down. Word is mine, he be charging us too much for these pounds. I'm too much for these clowns, I need to come down. Spread out like a shotgun round. Top our sound, Rich Bob is top of the town. It's shocking the stamp. Glock cock, popping the sounds. Big pop with a crown, my pop stop coming around. That's why I'm down, I need to get up. Feet don't spinny, spit up. Get paper hanging up. Get my dick sucked. Fire your body up like Nip Tuck. My attitude is bitch one. Mastered the art of stick ups. 52 cars to pick up. Send 52 bars to hit your whole belongs with you.
Start a clean and tan outfit.
Military man.
Money bone the face and that low. Military. Knife vision goggle. Sharp knives and dog cat. Third world country. Commissars and
body back.
Warfare's everywhere. Push a tackle. Never lag.
Strategic planning to get you through like my granddad.
Man, water man. The internet. We all been had. Ask the food factory. You long on. Being tracked.
Dead it.
They always had to drop some phone tech. Shit kickers on. Stomp through the jungle. We
throw the bat.
You and soldiers don't speak your language. How we at? Waiting on the call to start. The internal.
Nicki Minaj bump me to Minaj. Bump mansion for car garage. Hood niggas don't mingle with stars. Bad mommy don't speak English. Give me massage. She like the raw. She fuck my whole entourage. She throw vanilla Dutchess on the entourage. I'm in what's happening. Life rerun. Wayne and Rod. Be the flame. spark. Oh. And you can't contain a thing of ours. But like, I want my name in stars. Fuck stars. Insert my name in charts. Grandmoms
should have
told you not to play with
golf. Don't stay in one spot. Leave you with a dumb motherfucker.
Now you a city lock.
Yes, real estate, music in the fuse box. No snack chain from off book
to the country blocks.
Music is for everything like Dippy.
I can't stop.
But under the surface,
wild style when I drop.
And I say the victim's choice like X when it's time to come. If you talk about something with your lips,
it's time to rock.
Come again, that's why the bank is all wild high. Store counts effect.
Never know.
From the food kitchen to the trunk, and out the trunk, or my man running around.
Right there, he got it locked.
On your social networks, download and let it pop. Get followers like the old rock.
Spit the tape, that real hot hip hop. Jersey Fresh Jam. Shout out to Jersey Hip Hop, Jersey Run.
Shout out to Mr. Sickle. Sickle in the building.
By the name of Mr. Fickle, and you are now tuned in to Side B TV with my man Phil Jackson, the Divine Drummer.
Movie or nothing. I said movie or nothing. Motion picture shit.
Always in the studio, the club, I grind.
My baby girl always got questions.
Yes, this music thing is a different love.
Okay.
Yeah, she just wanna be in my presence.
Grade A weed, high quality wine. Making that good quality, lack quality time. Oh yeah, wifey ain't having it. She got passionate. She said it's hard, better pick. Mock drafting it. I'm laughing, chick. See what you do to me. These niggas ain't experienced shit, but puberty, yeah, she's so glued to me. We got joint friends, threw it all stuck together, like a joint twins. She had a breaking point, and she tried screaming. She said she hung around enough, like dry cleaning. Ultimatums to make up sex, hair get messy. She appreciate AP, but love Eric Presley. She don't take for granted anything I grind for. She just asking for more time, yeah, an encore. More acclamation, we just straight text. She tryna rehearse, yeah, practice safe sex.
I'm always in the studio, the club, I grind.
My baby girl always got questions.
This music thing is a different love than ours.
Yeah, she just wanna be in my presence, and I love
always it. Always in the studio, the club, I grind.
My baby girl always got questions.
Thing is a different love than ours. Yeah, she just wanna be in my presence, and I love that.
What's the difference
for the rest of the night? Am I told you I got a session in South Jersey?
Oh yeah. You think I could see you before you leave?
Maybe. I told you I ain't driving.
I'm always in the studio, the club, I grind.
My baby girl always got questions.
This music thing is a different love than ours.
Yeah, she just wanna be. My presence.
It's a club night, I don't wait in line, she said. It's like she got benched, she just want playing time, she said. No offense, we ain't sex in a month. Then she pulled down my pants and started checking for bumps. I told her, knock it off, I ain't get fed. Shit, no coin toss, shit, I ain't get head. I'm in Mayor House Studios, patroning a client. Then it got late night, like Conan O'Brien. She interrupted, pardon me. Acting all foolish. Then she said, how about you put me on your to-do list? I said, it's really kinda cool you wanna spend time. I love it and I hate it, y'all. It's really just a thin line. I wanna watch shows and get a little shutter. And she said she tryna roll just with a little butter. Oh man, you gotta love it. Without her, I feel naked. She always throwing something. Most of the time I can't make it. Cause I'm always in the studio, the club, I grind.
My baby girl always got questions.
This music thing is a different love than ours.
Yeah, she just wanna be in my presence, and I love
always
it.
Always in the studio, the club, I grind.
My baby girl always got questions.
This music thing is a different love than ours.
Yeah, she just wanna be in my presence, and I love that.
What's going on? This is Phil. Once again, Side B TV at Jersey Fresh in Trenton, New Jersey. Look, I was doing another interview, and shout out to all the artists that I interviewed a couple minutes ago. But when I saw this man walk up, I was like, yo. Not only is he a legend, he's my teacher. Because as you know, I'm at WPRB. He was at WPRB first. He started this whole thing, man. And I want to say, what's up to G, man? G the promoter, what's going on, man?
What's going on, man? Just back in Jersey, checking out Jersey Fresh. This is where real hip hop is at.
Look, before we start, I just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for hip hop, even in Jersey, because you, when you were at WPRB back in the day, you broke some crazy records. You helped a lot of cats out, from Naughty by Nature to Wu-Tang. So, I don't know, I'm speechless right now, man, because this is my teacher right here. I'm straight up, this is my teacher right here. So what's been going on with you, man?
Nothing much. I mean, first off, I got to say rest in peace to Tony D.
Rest in peace, Tony.
You know, because Tone was such a big part of all that. So, you know, definitely rest in peace to Tone. You're missed, man. You never got the credit you deserve. So, you know, got to say that first off. Me, I'm doing a bunch of things. I'm still working with some of the Wu artists here and there. I'm working with my man GZA, still doing some stuff with Master Killer, Deck. I mean, pretty much I'm on tap when they need help. I'm there. But still working with GZA like pretty much all the time right now. We're about to try to get his merchandise up again, try to get a website launched again for him, and you know, same thing with Master Killer, try to get a lot of that stuff up and rolling. Working with my man Jimmy Mack from Bulldog Bikes, New York company, but he's in old head from South Jersey. He used to come up to PRB too, so came out here to check this out. I got to roll up to, actually, Mullally Park is doing a benefit up in New York, so like a BMX skateboard jam. So kind of roll here, roll there, doing a little bit of everything. So.
Yeah, now, like, a lot of people really don't know that much, like what you do on the side. Is that your side, or like your main thing, like the BMX bike?
I mean, that's a side thing. That's always been, even back when I had PRB, like I grew up racing BMX. So it was like, even when I was doing the Raw Deal, I still was racing in the very first part of that. So always got a love for BMX. So it's like, you know, my man Chad Kagey, he just got injured out in the Dew Tour. So it's like cats like that, you know, try to take care of them, shout out to them, you know, tie in the music, hip hop, bikes, everything, you know. So it's a little bit of a little bit of everything I got going on.
Now, I seen footage where you were at the B-Boy barbecue out in Philly. Mm-hmm. And the one person asked you about hip hop, the state of hip hop. Could you tell everybody, like, can you break it down, like, your feelings about the state of hip hop right now?
I mean, right now, hip hop is alive in this. You know, it's alive in the streets, the stuff they play on the radio. I mean, other than underground shows, like college shows, the commercial radio stuff, people don't realize it's mass marketed. You know what I mean? You can go back in the day when we were doing PRB, you know, the commercial radio DJs were allowed to play some things, but they couldn't play as much as like college radio could. But what you don't realize now is, like, if you look back in the days, back in the 60s, 70s, 50s, every city had a different sound. There was the sound of Philadelphia. You know what I mean? You won't get that anymore, because why? They're playing the same stuff all over the country. They've taken away the liberty of the commercial DJs to even have the mix shows. And so what they're, you know, people don't realize, you're being fed this stuff. You turn on BET. BET is a black channel, but it's owned by Viacom, which is a white company. And so what are they playing on there? They're not playing anything that's positive. They're playing all the negative stuff, you know? And it's like, that's what's happened now with the culture. It's like, B-Boy culture is alive, but it's underground. You know what I mean? When we first started doing the shows with Wu-Tang, I was the only white kid in Wu-Tang shows. You know what I mean? I went in places in the hood that people were like, you know? And now you go to shows and it's like, it's crazy, because so much is like, the real hip hop shows is like, mostly a lot of white kids now. So it's like, you know, in that period of like when Wu-Tang first came out to now, it's totally different. And these cats today that are on the radio and video, they see like 30 times more money than Wu-Tang ever saw or is even still seeing. You know, so it's just, you know, nobody's saying anything on the radio. It's all like Simple Simon, Mother Goose, like nothing of anything. You got little kids walking around singing this stuff, and it's not doing any knowledge to anything. You know, the messages are all gone. The days of KRS, the days of Rakim, like, you know, KRS would drop a rhyme before, and you'd be looking in a book to find out what he was talking about. And they don't, you know, what you hear now, what do you hear now? It's all simple. It's what I call fast food of hip hop.
No, you're absolutely right. But do you see like a change? Do you think that it's gonna turn back around, getting back to like lyricism? You know, just the whole b-boy atmosphere.
I would hope so. I mean, you know, even when Wu-Tang dropped, it changed music. I mean, when RZA was first trying to shop the record, all these labels were like, No, it's too many artists. It's too hardcore. The beats are too grimy. But look what it did. It changed hip hop. You know, the same time, Mobb Deep, The Alcoholics, like all the groups, it changed hip hop. It's been going downhill for a long time. It's all about the money. It's about cars. Nobody's saying nothing. I mean, it's hard to say because it's like now there's the real artists, they don't have an avenue other than the internet. You know, so it's like in college radio. You know, so it's harder for people to get out there because they can't get the mainstream play. And all these companies, I mean, you're looking, you know, it's like, you know, Radio One, Clear Channel, all those companies that own all the radio stations except for the college stations. So they're telling all the DJs and the program directors what to play.
Exactly. Yeah,
so,
I know how it is.
I mean, you know, so it's crazy. I mean, real hip hop is still alive. It'll never die. Like the culture still remains. Like this is an example of it today. But as far as like getting it in the mainstream, I don't think it's going to happen.
What do you have coming out? Because do you want to let that out the bag? Because you just told me something interesting off camera. Do you want to let people know about that? What you got cooking up?
No, I mean, right now we got stuff in work. So, I mean, it's like working with some of the Wu Cats, it takes a while for some of this stuff to like happen because, you know, they're working on different albums, different projects. So it's like we got stuff coming. Wu ain't dead. Wu will never die. So, I mean, you know, it's like, I mean, Jizza's been working. He's got Liquid Swords Part 2, which would have been this year, but it might be later. He's got the Wu documentary he's been working on for over 10 years of filming, and he's got stuff on that, let me tell you.
It's crazy.
I was on the floor rolling. There is some funny footage. And I mean, you know, it's like, you know, hip hop, I mean, got Rock the Bells coming up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So there's a lot of stuff still going on, but compared to, you know, what you're hearing on the radio, what gets pushed, it's like now you got to, you know, back in the day, you'd have to go to a record store and you'd have to dig through and find out what the DJs, what the newest, hottest thing was. Even record stores are dying now. So it's like now there's so much on the internet that it's like you really got to dig. You know what I mean? There's like, everybody wants to be a rapper. Everybody's got a YouTube video. 90% of the cats don't even have talent. You know, it's like, I don't even rhyme, but I hear stuff on the videos. I'm like, I could even, whatever. But I mean, you know, hip hop is alive. You just got to dig. You know what I mean? It's like, it's still out there. There's a lot. I've seen MCs out here. I know from back in the days of PRB. I mean, you know, all these cats now, this is a sore point with me, is the whole thing with Jersey right now. Cats are like, oh, we're going to put Jersey on the map. I'm like, Jersey's been on the map. Do your history. You know what I'm saying? Poor Righteous Teachers, right from Trenton. You know what I mean? YZ, Almighty and KD Ranks. Like, there was a lot, Boulevard Mossy, a lot of groups in Trenton. Tony D had that moaning beat sound that he was doing that for years. So it's like, you know what I mean? Half these cats that are coming out, They're following what they hear on the radio, and they're making something up, and they're like, you know, I heard this song, somebody did the cover, like, we be on that Jersey, we be on that. I'm like, how you gonna, like, come up with something original? Jersey was known for being original, you know what I mean? And it's the same thing with Philly. You know, Philly had its own style, and it still does in a lot of ways, but all these new cats out there, come up with your own style, be original, don't do what's on the radio.
Hey, man, how can people get in contact with you?
I mean, I'm on Facebook. You can find me under G the Promoter. That's the best way to find me right now. So,
hello, man. I want to thank you, G the Promoter, my teacher. I salute you. I bow down to you. No, really, because you inspired me you know, listening on Thursday nights when you broke the woo, and you know, I still see the plaques at PRB, and when I walk through the hallway, it screams G, the promoter. And I want to thank you, man.
But it's, you know what? I'm glad to see somebody still carrying it on. You know what I mean? That's what's important to me, that it keeps going. You know what I mean? Keep real hip-hop alive. I mean, that's what it is. You know what I mean? There were people before me that helped me get onto that. You know what I mean? So it's like, it's important to keep that alive. I'm glad to see that somebody is.
The Raw Deal, Vibes and Vapors, now Side B TV. I'm in pretty good company. I got a long way to go to be in the ranks of this guy right here. But I want to thank you again, man. Thank you. Hey, look, Side B TV with your man Phil, Divine Drummer, G the Promoter. Man, we out of here, man.
Rhyme edit, rhyme edit, Cecile Oprah. Rhyme hookie, turn a bookie like a plate of Oprah. Steal the fakes, the blind fakes, the interlopers. I cross over like Wade on a shakedown. It's not drug dealers and killers that's holding weight now. The great sounds alive in a revamp. Not from Miami, but my heat can make a door pick. You caught a glance, but your business is within the tunnel. The rhyme punches like the impact of brass knuckles. The mind infants, the nipples, they all suckle. Trying to uphold the image that I never loved you. See, we can do it how you want. If you really want to, but give a fresh amazing lead with the steady 1-2-2. With the stage we stepping to, with the Undertaker missing, we still will bury you. Come on, y'all. Yeah, DJ D. Yeah, turn it up one time. Yeah, y'all ready for one more time? Here we go. Yeah, check it. What we came in to do? Yeah, yeah, louder, 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 louder. Yo, rock the bells, 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 louder. NJ, lead it louder. One time, rock the bells.
TV with your man Phil and Divine Drummer. We took a little break, but my cameraman was like, yo, you have to get this footage of this man right here and this man right here. Who am I talking about? DJ Priority, Venomous 2000, Ultra MC. What's going on, man? How you been doing?
All right, man. I'm maintaining, brother. You already know.
hey, look, man. I think, shout out to all the performers that are here. Shout out to graffiti artists and all that. But fam, you took it to another level with your, I respect everybody's performance here, but you turned it up a little. It's always like that one guy that gets, that always has to kickstart it back, and you did it, man. Congratulations on that.
I appreciate it, man. Honestly, man, I'm just, you know what I mean, just trying to make music, trying to have fun with it, and just keep it real with myself, man. Like, I mean, it's the spirit of hip-hop that moves me. So when you see that energy on stage, that's energy that I've accumulated from listening to cats like Rakim, cats like Black Thought, cats like Nas, you know what I mean, even Jay-Z, even the new cats, because they inspire me. Even though I may not like their stuff, they give me reason to really rock harder, you know? So, when I turn that energy, it's like, you know what I mean, any pain that I'm dealing with, any feelings that I'm having, all of that stuff is expressed and release, you know what I mean, in the performance, man. So that's it, man. I'm just rocking, just having fun with it.
Man, you could tell by your music that you really have fun with. And the one thing about his project that's out now, not even that his project that's out now, but his music, the one thing I noticed, I never had to edit anything from you.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you go through your stages of development. When I first started out, my brother Trey, shout out to my brother Big Trey. He used to always tell me, like, yo, you doing the cursing, this is not really you. I mean, even though we grew up in the area where we were exposed to it and everything like that, we weren't raised like that. So he was like, yo, listen, if you can't be real in your music, maybe you shouldn't be doing it. So, you know, it took a while for me to, like, learn. And it really changed, man, with the birth of my daughter. She just turned 6. You know what I mean? I wanted her to be able to listen to my music and me play it for her appreciate it, and her, you know what I mean, her mother, my family, my mom, not really, you know, having some type of feelings about the music that I'm putting her onto, especially if it's coming from me. So, you know what I mean? It's not like I'm doing it to, to like cater to some audience. It's just like, I don't know, man. I guess sometimes filling in with a curse word is because of the lack of using, you know, another word or finding another word to substitute it. So, man, it's like I don't even think about it anymore. You know, it just comes to me, man. I don't claim any ownership to the lyrics. It was all from divine higher forces, and I just translate it on paper. That's it.
How do you describe your style?
Like I said, it's accumulation of just all the things that I've experienced, all the things that I've read, all the things that I've seen, all the artists that I've listened to, all the genres of music from country to blues to jazz.
You're a real artist.
Yeah, in a sense, yeah. I mean, you know, that's why now I'm getting into the photography and the video, and I'm starting to see, like Dead Press said, you know what I mean? It's even though I'm in the hip hop thing, but it's like bigger than that. I mean, it's bigger than just the MC and then the rhyming. It's, I mean, look where we at now. You know, it's the graphing, it's the B-boys, you know what I mean? It's a whole culture. So I'm just trying to diversify myself, and I don't even like using the term try, man. I'm just doing me. That's it. I'm just doing me, bro.
Hey, tell me about the new project that you have out now.
Well, there's several, but the main one with my man DJ Priority, Fresh Amazingly, it's a project that we dropped back in February with Manny Konecki Pro. Shout out to my man Respect the God and my man DJ Black Panther. It was just, you know what I mean, a combination, me and his brother, like, getting up in the studio out in Paterson, New Jersey, listening to some beats, me feeling it, and like, yo, let's create something dope. It started off with, you know, just doing a couple tracks, and I was like, yo, why don't we just turn it into an album? He was with it. He'll send me a beat, I'll drop a song, send me another two beats, drop two more songs, and just, you know, started growing and evolving from that, man.
Yo, your album is incredible. I played it on the radio show. I get a lot of good response from it. Are there any particular tracks that stand out in your project?
I would say the very first song that we made the video for, which is Amazingly Fresh, which is actually starring my daughter Ashe, you know, peace to her. It was just like, yo, let's just do some old basement, some Pete Rock, CL Smooth, some Guru Primo type, you know what I mean? Just rock, just have fun with it. Get the records in there, and we just roll rock, have my daughter make it fun. And that's what it just, you know what I mean? That right there is what turned Fresh Amazingly into like something super, I guess, and spectacular, man. Just, you know what I mean? Just capturing those visuals and having that raw beat with the cuts, my daughter on it, was just crazy, man, you know? I would say Amazingly Fresh definitely is one. Soul Sensation with M. Josephine, which is the single that we got the video out for. The Takeoff is another joint. That's the first song on the album. We got a video out for that. What else, P? What would you say? Another standout track. Oh, definitely Rhymes Could Do It Right with my man John Robinson, my man Tywan Davis out in Chicago, and also my man Ty from the Bush.
Yeah. Hey, look, I'm going to get back to you in a minute.
No doubt.
But I want to get the man up here because... It was crazy. I'm talking to my man, Father Ramsey, over there. And, you know, we're listening to the music and this Venomous is set. And, you know, we hear all this cutting and scratch. I'm like, yo, that's a dope song. My cameraman and A. Slaughter wrote, nah, he's doing that right now. So this is the man that was doing that. DJ Priority, what's going on, man?
Good, man. What's good? Peace. DJ Priority now.
So what have you been up to, man?
A lot of stuff. I mean, I work with him. He keeps me busy almost 24/7, this guy, man. Like, he's almost eliminating other artists from my little camp that I got of, like, beats and stuff like that, because he works hard, keeps busy. Music, videos, everything. Besides that, you know, do radio, give other artists beats, a lot of DJing, a lot of cuts for people, you know, just hip-hop.
Now, you wear a lot of hats. You say, you know, videos, DJing, radio. What do you like the most out of everything that you just named? What do you like to do the most?
Well, it's DJing. I've been DJing for like 15 years. You know what I mean? Since like
15 years. You look like you're like 20 years old.
I'm 21, turning 30 in my late 30s, but nah. You know what I mean? I started like around 93. DJing, like Gemini tables, everybody, you know, the old school Radio Shack mixer and everything. But it just evolving, to the battle DJs, evolving into like really doing clubs and then working with artists. And then I picked up with the beats and then just combined both of them, and this is where you got them. This is where you got me, right?
That's what's up. Hey, look, we're going to wrap it up, but how can people get in contact with you?
People can get in contact with me at my Gmail. That's djpriority@gmail.com. Everything is spelled correctly. djpriority@gmail. The Twitter, YouTube. I'm on basically every social network under DJ Priority. So just Google me, and I'll hit you back, and we can chat it up about hip-hop or music or whatever.
That's what's up. Hey, Venomous, how can people get in contact with you?
First of all, you could go to my music website, venomous2000.com. That's venomous2000.com. Or you can hit me up on my photography, my business site. It's V2GPhotography.com. You can check me out on Twitter, venomous2000, Facebook, venomous2000, MySpace, venomous2000. Anything venomous2000, you'll catch me on it. That's it, man.
Hey, look, man. DJ Priority, Venomous 2000. You hear them on Sabi Radio. They just toured down at Jersey Fresh. We got my man Feed. He's the host. Divine Drummer. He just walked past. Yo, man, we out of here, man. Peace. Sabi TV, Sabi Radio. It's your man Phil, Divine Drummer out here. Yo, man, I didn't even come. I came around here, but this might be the grimiest underground feel to the game. Get all this, man. We're on dirt. And we have, look, yeah, can you excuse me for a minute? We got like Lays right here. You got my man Serge back there. He's politicking. I mean, you still got the graph writers out here. Oh, man.
What's up, man?
You came on my show last night.
Yeah, definitely.
Now you're on the video show. Okay. Tell you about who you are, man.
Black Collar Biz, man, you know. Shout out to Trenton. Shout out to Side B Radio, Divine Drummer. You know what I'm saying? Hook Jackson, baby, we here, man.
Tell me, man, what's going on with you, man? Because, like, you got, like, a lot of stuff going on, like we talked about last night on the radio show. The one thing I respect about you, you work with a lot of artists out there. And that's the one, I mean, you know, I can't put you in one category, you know, mainstream, underground. I mean, you're just the MC. So what else is going on with you, man?
Hey, man, I'm just trying to make good music, make moves, you know what I mean, for the town, because I look at it like a lot of people paying attention to what's going on in Jersey, not just Trenton, but in Jersey. So, you know what I mean, I'm trying to take it to the top of the globe, man. I got Forever Black coming out. Like I said last night, Casso doing the cover, you know what I mean? Shout to my son, he around here somewhere, you know what I'm saying? He always, like, on set with me when I'm rapping, like, he want to be the next big thing, you feel me? So I do it for the family, man. You know what I mean, family over everything, FOA, NBA, never be alone. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, you know, that's the one thing I like about you. Oh, that's your son right there? Hey, how you doing? What's your name, man?
Ray.
Ray? And who's this individual right here? It's your dad? Is he your favorite rapper? Who's your favorite rapper?
I don't know.
No, you're supposed to say your dad, man. Say my daddy.
I think my dad.
Okay. Hey, look. Yeah. Hey, man. I interviewed a lot of people out here. Mm-hmm. And shout out to all the artists out here. But you mentioned family,
right?
And you actually had your son out here. I mean, how does that make you feel? I mean, for him, like, to look up to you like that, not just as a rapper, but you're so responsible as a parent. I mean, that's what's up, man. I mean, does that really keep you grounded, like, what you do?
I believe so, man. Like, more or less, like, I don't hang around with too many friends. Like, all these cats you see, this is family, you know what I'm saying? And we just all kick it, top of the globe. You got Ant Live, Hard Work, Artwork, Steve, he do the graphics. You got AJ Tudder, TOTG, you know what I mean, TNT. But basically, like, I hang with my family, man. Like, we all trying to make it. And at the end of the day, it, more or less, if you're not rolling with your family, you messing up, because it's family first. That's what it's supposed to be, you know what I mean? And that's how I'm coming, man. And they my motivation, man.
That's what's up now. Tell me about the project, man, because you gave it to me last night. Okay. I'm definitely going to listen to it. Actually, I'm going to play one of the tracks tomorrow. But tell me about your project, man.
My project, more or less, you know what I'm saying? It got my homie TJ Gilliam on there, Monet Cherie, Turnpike to the Ant Live, a couple other artists. I'm trying to get Serge on there before I get the final copy out. You know what I mean? It's one dope track. It's for the children, actually. I don't know any artists out right now with a song for the kids. So We did a little mega joint for the kids off a DJ Hellfire beat. Okay. More or less, my album is Yours Truly. Basically, like, my message to the people, and I bring a little bit of knowledge, you know what I mean? I bring some bars, a little bit of energy, and I just try to be creative every time I go on with a concept. I don't like writing if I don't got a concept, you know what I'm saying? A lot of artists lose track of what, you know what I mean, the elements of hip-hop, you know what I'm saying? More or less, you got to have that concept sometimes. You got to be creative. If you could rap about being a victim underneath a bridge with your legs tied to the bottom of the bridge, thinking about your last moments of life, how would you write about that? You know what I'm saying? If you could write about being a leaf falling from a tree, you should write about that. You know what I'm saying? That's called being creative. A lot of these cats ain't creative no more. You know what I'm saying? So I try to embody that creative point that people are lacking and missing right now. So that's what Black Collar Biz do. So y'all check that out. Forever Black. It won't be on the internet until I sell a certain amount of copies in the streets. We going old school on them this time. You know what I'm saying? So y'all be in tune with that. Y'all going to see me around doing shows. Shout out to Jersey Fresh. Shout out to Casso. Garden Variety. We here, man.
Now, you didn't perform yet. Now, you're about to go on, right?
Yeah, I'm about to go on actually in like 15 minutes.
Oh, man. So, like, you're not going to be closing it out, but how does that make you feel? You're one of the main acts. I mean, how does that, is this your first time performing at Jersey Fresh?
To answer your second question, this is my second time. Okay. I performed last on the last one.
Really?
Yeah, I performed last on the last one. I had the band out here, shout out to Smash and Grab. But it just feels good. Like, I don't think of it more or less like who goes on, when they go on. As long as you're here and there's people here and they paying attention to what you're doing, that's what it's all about. So, I mean, if it's two people here, I'm still rapping. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what it's all about. I don't leave the stage until my time's up. You feel me?
How can people get in contact with you?
You catch me on the Facebook, Black Collar Biz. Black Collar like a shirt. Biz, B-I-Z. You catch me on Twitter. WhatUpCollar, topoftheglobe.com is the website. Or you can just Google me. You know what I'm saying? We here. T-O-T-G's here. Phil Stacks is here. And my son's still trying to get some airtime, but he used to this. He always know when daddy around the mic, I need some airtime too. So that's how he be coming. What's up, man?
Hey, you know what?
I got you in a second, all right?
I normally end it like, I want to thank you, but I was going to end it with him, but you know. But you know, I want to thank you, man, because I respect what you're doing. I love your music. Keep doing what you're doing. I mean, I see you blowing up. Well, you're already blowing up, but I see you doing like bigger things, and I just want to thank you, man. I mean, like, you're one of the guys in Trenton that people better watch out for. And the one thing about it is you work with everybody. I want to thank you again, man.
Appreciate you. Hook Jackson, man. WPRB. I appreciate y'all, man. We here. I ain't really got too much to say. Humility is the key to success, man. It's from the heart, man. Hate is another version of love, so it starts with love. You gotta like something enough to hate it, so keep loving shit, man. That's all I'm gonna say. If you can't cuss on TV.
Nah, no, don't worry about it. Hey, look.
Peace, man. It's all love, man. Hook Jackson.
Hey, I'm here. So, and look at all the people around, man. Get a glimpse of everybody around. I see a girl. She almost fell back there. But hey, man, we're out here. Sabi TV, Sabi Radio, WPRB 103.3 FM. Me and Devon Drummer, we're about to do the wrap up in a minute. Let's go try to grab him real quick. Peace, I'm out.
This is G the Promoter, formerly of Raw Deal, WPRB, Wu-Tang Clan Promotions. Checking out Side B TV with my man Phil and Devon Drummer. Keep watching. This is where real hip hop is.
Side B TV with your man Phil. We're out here in Trenton, New Jersey. Jersey Fresh event. We got my man, Mr. Fickle. What's going on, man?
What's good, Phil? What's good, Phil? Everything good, man.
Hey, man, look, I apologize. I didn't catch your performance, but I heard it was dope. Is this your first time actually performing at the Jersey Fest event?
I'm a virgin to the Jersey Fest. This is my first time. I'm enjoying it. I'm loving it.
What's your take on this whole event?
Like pure hip hop, pure hip hop in its rarest form. You're getting the graffiti. You're getting the people coming together, and you're getting the artists.
That's just, hey, look, man. When I first met you, you hit me off with music. He's from B-Boy Academy, Camden, New Jersey. I just want to congratulate you on the success that you have, because you've been putting out some good music, man.
Hey, yo, I've been doing a lot of good things. For the last year, I put out a project, The Streets Can't Tell Me Nothing, and a lot of credit have to go to you. From my grind and exposure and the radio, you know what I mean, if it really wasn't for you, I wouldn't be where I'm at. So,
what is next for Mr. Fickle? Because I know that we talk constantly on a daily basis. I know you don't want to let too much out the bag. Oh, you let? Okay, well, go ahead then.
You got a website coming. You got T-shirts coming. You got a new album. It's called The Hip Hop Nerd, Mr. Fickle, The Hip Hop Nerd.
When does that come out?
That come out, I would say, like a good 2 months.
Okay.
Good 2 months from now. So, a lot of things is coming out of Camden that's real positive music.
Any special collabs are going to be on that project?
That's what I'm not going to let out. You're going to have to get the project to see who's on there.
That's what's up. Now, how can people get in contact with you, man? Because like a lot of people want to try to get in contact with you with those collabos, doing shows. And you actually did a show last night. How was that, too? Awesome.
I tore that thing down. I didn't even go on front. I tore that thing down. First show in Philly, and I'm 5 minutes from Philly. But I'm all booked up now. Got a lot of joints, a lot of performances in Philly coming up. So, yeah, September 9th at the Trocadero, Mr. Fickle will be in the building.
Hey, man, how could people get in contact with you?
People get in contact with me through Facebook, which Mr. Fickle, M-R-F-I-C-K-L-E, or Twitter, same name, or YouTube, or my email, MrFickle707@hotmail.com.
Hey, man, you got any shout-outs before we get out of here?
I want to shout-out B-Boy Academy. I want to shout-out Side BTV. I want to shout-out all of Jersey, all of hip-hop, and everybody.
Look, man. Let me tell y'all real quick. Get a close-up on me, because this is my serious voice. This is my serious journalistic voice. Hip-hop in the state of New Jersey, underground. This is one of the guys. You really got to support it. I want to thank you, man. He gives me music on a constant basis. Mr. Fickle, he's everywhere. Jersey Fresh. I'm exhausted. My cameraman's working overtime. We're about to go get something to drink. We got my man A Slaughter back here. Devon Jump. Oh, there go Devon Jump. Hey, come here before we get out of here. Hey, man. Spittertainment real quick.
No doubt.
They killed it, man. What was your thoughts on that?
Yeah, they bodied.
Hey, man.
It's all right, man.
How you taking all this stuff in, man? My co-host. How you taking all this in?
It was good, man. It was a good thing. It was beautiful. Great day. The culture, why not?
Now, do you have any shout outs?
Everybody, man. The graffiti artist, man, I respect this right here. You know what I mean? I'm definitely not letting this go in vain. I'm just amazed how they seeing this, because me with a can in my hand, phew, terrible. You know what I mean? But I guess on the flip side, I'm a producer, so I can relate. When you go in, you go in.
Now, you're a talk show host. You're a slash TV talk show host, radio talk show host, but you're a producer. Now, how can people get in contact with you?
You can reach me at Divine Drummer, D-I-V-I-N-E, D-R-U-M-M-A-H. That's the trick, A-H instead of E-R, at gmail.com. You can reach me on Facebook, Divine Drummer. You can reach me on Twitter, Divine Drummer. Get at me, please.
Hey, look, two of my favorite artists right here, Mr. Fickle.
So you already
know. Yeah, and they collab.
Black Collar told me yesterday. He said, oops.
Oh, no, not going to let that. We're not going to let that out the back. Not going to let that.
Okay.
We got one of Camden's finest. We got one of Trenton's finest. Mr. Fickle, the Vine Drummer, Side BTV. Y'all ready to go get something to drink, man?
I'm ready.
All right, let's go. What's out, man?
Oh, man. Trenton in the building, Jersey in the house, y'all. My brother lost his first son when he was one. And I done been to the point that these chickens call me a bum. This life in the streets is no fun. The family got the nerve to look like lot of block and a gun. If it's trouble, dog, you pop and you run. I'm the reincarnation of Biggie, Big L, Pocket, Big Pun. It's more lot of freaky time. The streets here to claim rap commercial niggas. No more squeaking by. Your bars is weak and they dry. And I'm hotter than Hell's Kitchen, motherfucker. So we could fry. That's your gangsters, nigga. Yo, he could die. Let the slugs fly. When the thug cry, fuck them so-called tough guys. My whole team is gritty, dog. We don't dance, we must lie. Trenton, New Jersey, the capital. No
don't make me clap at you. See your fake ways, that's how these masters do. Got the gap to you, clap the back of food. Snatch a plate, knead up, stash of your food. Shoot it up, loot it up, and spit it back at you. Move to the side, we coming through the back, dude. We coming through the front. Stack them with the deck and ask them what he want. Give you a taste of this shotgun pump, funk for you fake chumps. You can run, but you dare not jump, cause here I come. East Trenton, USA is where I'm from.